Hello, students of the ninth grade. Here we meet again, but this time we are going to have some speaking exercises. You are going to have some useful language we use when talking about careers or jobs. Here we're going to have a discussion about career options. You are going to listen to some sentences. These sentences are between a student and a career guidance counselor. Let's have a quick reading at them and to focus to say who says each sentence. The first one, have you decided what you'd like to study? So what do you think? Who says the sentence, the student or the counselor? It is, of course, the counselor. Then we have, I'm still not sure what's the best for me. So this sentence is said by a student, and most students nowadays are dealing the same difficulty, are dealing the same problem, because they don't know what is the best thing for them. Then we have, how are you doing in biology and chemistry? These are some questions that the career counselor can ask to a student. So they are said by a counselor. I usually get top marks. Who can get top marks? Of course, students. So these sentences are said by a student. Okay, we're here. Have you thought of about studying marine biology? And this sentence is said by a career guidance counselor. We are going to have a look at the dialogue as well. Then we have, that sound interesting. After someone gives you a suggestion, maybe the career guidance counselor has given an idea or an advice, the student might say, that sounds interesting. The last one, that's what I'm here for. And this is a sentence said by the guidance counselor because he is expressing to the students that it is his job to be there to help him. Now we are going to read the dialogue together to find out more. So as I said, it is a dialogue between Pat, who is a student, and the career guidance counselor. Pat has some difficulty in trying to understand what it is best for her to study at university. So schools abroad have a guidance counselor, a career guidance counselor, who gives you advice on what is best for you. And then it is you and your parents who decide what is the best for you. Now let's listen to this dialogue. Have a seat, Pat. Thanks. So, Pat, have you decided what you'd like to study at university? I've been thinking about it, but I'm still not sure what's the best for me. What kind of job do you think you might be happy doing? Well, I like the thought of working with animals, but I don't want to be a vet. I see. How are you doing in biology and chemistry? Very well. I usually get top marks. Well done. And how about your other subjects? I'm doing well in most subjects, except physics, art, and music. Have you thought about studying marine biology? That sounds interesting. Why don't you think about it? Discuss it with your parents, and we will talk again next week. Okay, thank you. You have been a great help. You are welcome. That's what I'm here for. Now we are going to have an exercise. You are going to read the dialogue. Here it is, the dialogue again. Find phrases that mean, we have here five phrases, that these phrases have their synonyms in the dialogue. So let's see the phrases together. Here it is, I understand. What is another phrase in the dialogue having the same meaning? It is, I see. The next one is, what results are you getting in? So he's asking her about marks, right? So what is another sentence in the dialogue having the same meaning? And it is, how are you doing, for example, with your subjects? Then we have here, congratulations. What is another word for that? And it is, well done. So here it is, he's congratulating. When we congratulate something, we say congratulations or well done. And here it is in the dialogue. Then we have don't mention it. After somebody have said us thank you, we say don't mention it, and here it is, you're welcome, and in the dialogue it appears here. The last one, I'm only doing my job. So it is the sentence said by the counselor, and it is, that's why I'm here for, and in the dialogue, it appears in the last line. Now everybody, here we are going to have heteronyms. What are heteronyms? They are words which are written exactly the same, but they are spelled differently and they have a different meaning. Here there are a group of words. Let's practice reading these words together, and I'm going to help you with their meaning. So have a look here, M-I-N-U-T-E. We can read this word in two ways, minute, which means 60 seconds, or minute. Minute means very small. So as you can see, the word M-I-N-U-T-E can be read in two ways, minute or minute. Minute 60 seconds and minute means very small. Then we have live and life. Live is the state of living, while here live means broadcast, when you are in synchron in something. We have T-E-A-R. This word can be read in two different ways, tear or tear. When it is tear, it is rip, while tear are, it is liquids that comes out from our eyes. Pra tear gris dhe tear lot. Pra mund të shohim që fjala tear, pra që kemi këtu, mund të lexohet në dy mënyra, tear ose tear. Then we have read or read. Read is the process of reading a book, for example, while read is the past simple of the verb read. Then we have use and use. Then we have close and close. When we say close, it means near, while close is the opposite of open. Can you think of other words, which are heteronyms? You can find other words and report, give them to your friends to understand what is the meaning of those heteronyms words. Now we are going to come to practice the dialogue again, the useful phrases we use when we talk about careers, when someone is giving us some instructions or some ideas about our career. And here we have got the dialogue. There are omitted some phrases, Brian hequr disa fraza. We are going to read it and use the phrases in the correct box. So the phrases are, that's what I'm here for, that sound interesting, well done, I'm still not sure what's the best for me. So let's read the dialogue together to understand it better. So Becky, have you decided what you would like to study at university? I have been thinking about it, but I'm not sure what's the best for me. What kind of job do you think you might be happy doing? I think I'd like a job where I could help people. I see. How are you doing in biology and chemistry? Very well. I usually get top marks. So this person is congratulating, so we say well done. And how about other subjects like maths and English? I'm doing very well. Okay, how about studying medicine? You could become a doctor. And here there are left the phrases that sound interesting and that's what I'm here for. So what do you think, what phrase best fits here? It is, that sounds interesting. When someone says something that we really like, we can say this phrase. It might suit me, thank you. Not at all. And do you remember what was the phrase that the career guidance counselor told to or said to Pat in the previous dialogue? It was, that's what I am here for. Well, now it is your turn. You are going to practice writing a dialogue. Imagine you have a meeting with a careers counselor. Write a similar dialogue to the one below, to the one that you had actually in the previous slides. The useful language that you can use in your dialogue are here. I understand. What results are you getting in? Congratulations. Don't mention it. I'm only doing my job. I see. How are you doing in? Well done. You're welcome. You're welcome, sorry. And that's what I'm here for. So write your dialogue using these useful phrases and read it to your friends. Thank you for your attention.